Assalamu alaikum students. I hope you all are fine and in good health. So here we are going to start with English subject. As in yesterday's class, we did the recap of writing section and we covered two topics, formal and informal letter. As per the syllabus, you are having the other two topics, that is notice writing and story writing. So that is what we are going to cover in today's class. So first topic that we are going to see is notice writing. What is a notice? What is a notice? Yes, notice is nothing but that a piece of information. Okay, that notice is just a piece of information that is supposed to be passed to the front person, or in the front person can be many people. It can be in an organization, it can be school, it can be banks, it can be any notice, okay, to the general public. Okay, so it's just a piece of information that is supposed to be passed to the people. Okay, so what is a notice writing? Suppose when you write a notice for a school, okay, like there is one message that is supposed to be passed to the students, all the students of the school. So is the teacher going to go to every student and tell the information? No. Why will the teacher do that? What will the teacher do? Instead, they will just write one notice and display it on the board wherein the students can go and read. Yes, so that is a notice writing. Now, here is one example. As we are just doing the recap of writing section, I have taken a very easy topic. I am going to focus over here more on the format. I'm going to focus on the format, which are the points that you have to cover in the notice. Okay, with the help of this easy example. So as a question, you are head girl or boy of the school. Your school is organizing a tour to Rajasthan. Write a notice inviting students who want to join the tour. So now, for example, you are the head girl or head boy of your school. Okay, and you have to inform students regarding the tour to Rajasthan. Okay, the school has organized a tour to Rajasthan. Okay, and you have to give this information to the students. Now, are you going to go to every student? No, you just can write one notice on one paper and pass it in every class. Yes, so let's start now. See, how can you write a notice? So here is the answer that we can take. Okay, first point which is very much necessary for a notice, that is box. Okay, if you don't draw the box, your marks will be cut. Okay, so remember, your notice is always in a box. Okay, now the first thing you have to write is the name of the school. What are you going to write? Name of the school. Okay, the next line you have to, in bold letters, okay, in all capital letters, you have to write notice. Now let me write over here and show. On the top you have to write, suppose you write Matliwala Public School, full you have to write. Okay, and don't start from here and end it here, write it in the center only. Okay, and then below that, in capital letters, you have to write notice. Is it clear or not? So school's name will come first, then notice, then this two you will write in the center. Okay, then come to left hand side and you will write date. Okay, you will write date, write the date on which you are writing the notice. Okay, after date, you can leave one line or the next line in center again. You have to write the topic. What are you going to write? Topic. What is the topic over here? Tour to Rajasthan. So how are you going to do? Tour to Rajasthan. Okay, so topic. And then you have to start writing. So how you will start? You can just start by saying, this is to inform all the students. That is also the way you can write. How we can write? This is to inform all the students that our school is organizing a 5-day tour to Rajasthan. Okay, this is how you are going to begin the notice. How are you going to begin? This is to inform. Now, if you are writing it for students, you have to write, this is to inform all the students. Okay, suppose if you are writing as a secretary of the society, okay, you just have to write to the people of your society. So this is to inform, okay, the members of the society that so and so. You can continue with the topic. Okay, so here, as it is a tour to Rajasthan, how you write? This is to inform all the students that our school is organizing a 5-day tour to Rajasthan. Now this is the beginning line, and then you have to provide details, okay, about what you are informing. You have to provide detail about what you are informing. If you just simply write tour to Rajasthan, those who are interested, give the names or pay the money. But you haven't mentioned how much to pay. Okay, so you have to inform. You have to first read the topic. What are you going to do in the exam? Read the topic. After reading, note down the points that you have to write, which is necessary for the topic. Okay, and then write the notice. See, so over here, from which class to which class? Then date of departure, date of arrival. Date of departure, date of arrival is very much important, right? From which date to which date the tour will be there. So that also you have to mention. Those who are interested, main deposit. See, these are the important information. The cost is inclusive of sightseeing, boarding and lodging at 3-star hotel. Please do so by 12th July. So then other information is given that in this much amount, what are things are included? Okay, and which is the last date to inform. And then after writing the entire notice, left hand side you have to write your name, and in bracket you can write your designation. What you have to write? As per the format, designation. Designation means what's your position. You are a head girl, head boy, you have to mention that over here. Okay, so this is a simple format of a notice writing. Okay, you have to make a box, okay, in the center, name of the school, notice, date, topic. Then start writing, then name, designation. Okay, so these are things you have to cover in notice writing. I hope this is easy, okay, and you'll be able to score marks in this if you concentrate well and follow the rules of the format. And for the detailed video also, you can go in the explanation of notice writing. Now let's start with the next topic that we are going to cover today. That is story writing. Now story writing is nothing that whatever you wish to write, you can write. Okay, it's nothing like that. You'll be given some clues. You'll be given some clues. You can say some outlines. What is the meaning of outline? Some hints. Okay, we call it hints. So here, see, one easy story, the most easy story that we all know. Okay, I have given here clues. Okay, in the exam also you will be given like this. In between you will have this dot 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 dot. Okay, this does not mean fill in the blanks. Remember students, in previous years I have seen that many of them just fill the gaps by writing and on a the. This is not fill in the blanks. You have to complete the entire story. These are just the outlines that is given to you. These are just the hints that are given to you. Using this, you can write your story. Okay, you have to complete the whole story. Don't fill in the blanks with and the. Okay, So here first let me read the outlines. The mice in a house. Afraid of the cat. Hold a meeting. One proposes to tie a bell round the cat's neck. All agree. Who is to bell the cat? No mouse offers. The cat appears. All run away. So these are clues. Now after reading the clues, you know what's the story about. Cat and the mice, right? So the mice, now you know mice, they are afraid of cat because cat will eat mice, right? So the mice in the house, they are afraid of the cat. Okay, so the all the mice, they gather and they held a meeting and they decide that we need to tie a bell in the cat's neck so that whenever cat comes, we'll hear the sound of the bell so that we can all go and hide. Okay, so this was agreed upon. But then who will go and tie the bell? Okay, who will go and tie the bell? So they all were deciding, nobody was getting ready to go and tie the bell, and when they were discussing, this cat appeared and then everybody ran away. So this is the story, right? Now after reading clues, you will get a hint what the story is about. After you get the hints, okay, then you start writing a story. Okay, so the first step towards writing the story is, which is very important, that is topic. Okay, or you can say title. Okay, what you have to write? Title. If you don't write title, your marks will be cut. So suppose the next topic given over here is belling the cat. You can give the mice and the cat. Okay, you can give the title related to the story. So now, and then you have to start. And how every time a story starts? Once the mice living in a certain house were very unhappy, for a cat killed and ate many of them. Okay, so what happened, students? That once there were mice living in the house, they were very afraid of cat because cat used to eat them up. At last, they held a meeting to see how they could get rid of the cat. One mouse said they should leave the house. Another said they should not come out of their holes. Then a young mouse stood up and said, "Let us tie a bell around the cat's neck. Then when the cat comes, we shall hear the bell and can get out of its way." All the mice shouted, "Good." They all thought it was a very good plan indeed. Now an old mouse stood up and said, "The plan is no doubt good, but who will tie the bell around the cat's neck?" No mouse offered to do it. Suddenly the cat appeared and all the mice ran to their holes. So this is a story developed from the outlines given over there. Okay, if you want, you can write your imaginary things, you can give a twist and turn to the specified story. Okay, and how are you going to write? First, start with every time when you start a chapter in your books, do you see how they start? It's kind of an introduction that they are giving, okay? Then a deep, and then last they come to concluding lines. So this is how you can divide the story in three paragraphs also, okay? So make sure you write, okay, and don't write this short story, okay? This is just an example that I'm showing to you, okay? Write it according to the topic, according to the title, according to the hints, okay? And try to make it very interesting. Try to make it very interesting. This will help you in creative writing. Okay? It will develop your creative writing skills. So, I hope. Okay, so in story, there is no format. Just one thing you have to make sure, that you are writing a title. Give a title and then from next line, start writing the story. This is the format of story writing. So, here we finish with writing section recaps. Okay? See you in the next class, and all the best for the exams.